Are you coming up on that Creative Cloud subscription wondering if there's a cheaper option? Well, there might be, depending on your needs. Today, we're going to be talking about the differences between the Affinity Suite and Adobe Creative Cloud and see if Affinity will actually meet your needs as a designer. Hi, I'm Drew, and I've been teaching motion design and graphic design at university for a little over 5 years, and I'm a huge fan of both Adobe and the Affinity Suites, so let's get into it and see how they stack up. Both Adobe Creative Cloud and Affinity are popular software suites for creative professionals and enthusiasts, and they offer a range of really powerful tools for image manipulation, graphic design, and page layout. We're going to be focusing on Affinity Designer compared to Adobe Illustrator, Adobe Photoshop compared to Affinity Photo, and Affinity Publisher compared to Adobe InDesign. Adobe offers a ton of different software packages, but if you find yourself mostly using Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign, this video is definitely for you. Pricing is probably the biggest difference between the two, with Adobe opting for a subscription-only pricing model. Affinity's pricing is fairly straightforward. As of August 2023, the applications are available individually for $70 each for the Mac and Windows versions, and for $19 for the iPad versions. Of course, you can bundle all of them together and get all of the Mac, Windows, and iPad versions for $165. Adobe's pricing is a little bit more complicated since it is a subscription model. You can install software on as many computers as you like, but you can only run it concurrently on two computers at the same time. That means if you have it installed on a third computer, you'll need to sign out of Creative Cloud on one of them. Generally, Adobe offers three tiers of pricing. There's the monthly price if you just pay month to month. Then there's the price with a 12-month commitment. And then there's the paid upfront price, which in some cases gets you a discount, but not quite as much as just the 12-month commitment. Affinity makes a lot of sense for freelancers and really any designers who are just looking to save some money, especially since you get to keep the software and use it for as long as you want, and then you get to choose whether or not you want to upgrade when they release new versions. Speaking of saving money, for a single flat monthly rate, you can get access to millions of not only fonts, but also stock video, stock photos, graphic design templates, web templates, and more over at Envato Elements. Next time you're looking for any kind of creative assets to speed up production and streamline your workflow, head over to envatoelements.com. Photoshop and Affinity Photo. Both of these are really powerful raster editing suites. Photoshop, of course, needs no introduction. It's been around for decades, and you're probably familiar with it already. Over the last few years, though, Adobe has been adding a lot of AI tools to Photoshop, things like content-aware fill and the content-aware scale, and recently it's also added AI-assisted image resizing, which is really, really handy. We've also gotten a preview of some of the additional AI tools that are coming, and you can expect to get lots more AI assistance in Photoshop. Affinity Photo, on the other hand, is newer and more performant. It offers a much more streamlined interface, and even though it doesn't have all of the AI-assisted tools that Photoshop does, common tasks like masking are still exceptionally fast in Affinity Photo. Photo is also exceptionally well integrated in the Affinity Suite, and we'll get to that a little bit more when we talk about InDesign and Publisher. But you can count on Photo to be pretty compatible, since it will open not only its own Affinity files, but will also open Adobe Photoshop PSD files as well. Even if somebody else is working with Photoshop, you can still do a lot of the same things on that Adobe PSD and then send it back to them. We can't talk about raster editing without also talking about Lightroom, and unfortunately there is no analog in the Affinity Suite for Adobe Lightroom. When it comes to editing large batches of pictures when you come back from a shoot and you have hundreds or thousands of photos to unload from your memory cards, it can be really, really taxing to try to do that one by one in a system like Photo or Photoshop. That's where Lightroom comes in. You can apply batch edits to lots of photos all at once. And Photoshop integrates pretty tightly with Lightroom. It's not impossible to work with Photo and Lightroom. You can still export from Lightroom, bring things into Photo, and do whatever retouching you need to do there, and then bring it back into Lightroom. And since you can get Lightroom separately, it is possible to do that. Illustrator and Affinity Designer. For graphic designers out there, anybody working with vectors, obviously Illustrator's been around for a really, really long time. Illustrator has a number of really powerful tools like Image Trace, which lets you bring in raster graphics and turn them into vectors. Blend tools. It's recently added the 3D tools, so you can work with 3D shapes and lighting in Illustrator itself. It also has a really powerful symbol management system, so you can spray multiple instances of the same asset and then go and control the size and rotation and position with different symbol sprayer tools. One of my favorite things about Illustrator is the appearance panel, since you can stack not only multiple fills and strokes, but also multiple effects. Affinity Designer takes a much different approach to working with vectors. It's a much more streamlined interface and a lot faster to get things done. Things like clipping and masking and working with compound shapes is all just handled through the layers panel rather than having multiple other separate panels to manage those things. Designer also has a much larger library of parametric shapes, so things like gears and donuts that might require a compound shape in Adobe Illustrator can just be created with a parametric shape in Affinity Designer. One of the biggest things in Designer is that it has much better support for raster graphics through the pixel persona. So it's a lot easier to mix and match vector and raster elements within a single file. Having access to raster elements in Affinity Designer makes it a lot more streamlined for drawing and painting as well. Designer does have a symbol system, although it's a much different approach than what Illustrator has. You're not going to have like the symbol sprayer tools and be managing large groups of instances of assets, but you can reuse an asset and then go back and make changes to one of them and have those changes propagate to all of the different assets in the file, which is really, really handy. But again, it's a slightly different approach than Illustrator. Ultimately, the choice between Affinity Designer and Illustrator comes down to just how much you use the Illustrator tools like Image Trace and the Blend Mode and the 3D tools versus how much you would benefit from a smoother drawing and painting interface, the ability to mix and match raster and vector graphics. InDesign and Publisher are desktop publishing applications, and they're really catered more towards managing large groups of assets and really complex designs where you have multiple pages and you want to be able to manage all your text styles and layouts without having to do it individually for every single page. InDesign also has parent pages, so you can manage styles across multiple pages at once, as well as very powerful text styles and data merge capabilities. It integrates pretty well with other Adobe applications, and it is handy having the Creative Cloud Libraries features that you can just bring in assets that you've stored in Creative Cloud. In practice, though, integrating it with Photoshop is a little more clunky than you would expect. If you want to bring in a PSD file, for instance, and have that make live updates when you make changes in Photoshop, you will need to set up layer comps in Photoshop in order for that to work. Publisher is also fairly new, and its respective suite has actually only been around for a few years. Nessage is exceptionally performant, and it's probably the closest in terms of feature parity when you compare it to its Adobe analog InDesign. It has masters, it also has really powerful text styles, data merge capabilities, and lots of tools for managing tons and tons of assets all together. The only thing it's really lacking compared to InDesign is the ability to use those cloud features like libraries. There's one thing though that makes Publisher stand out as a clear choice that you might want to get even if you do have the Creative Cloud subscription. And that's its integration with Designer and Photo, because it includes Designer and Photo as personas. Publisher handles all of the file linking and all of that stuff. All you have to do is just bring in your files and then switch to the Photo interface or the Designer interface to work with rasters or vectors. When it comes to working with large documents, publications, presentations, and things like that, Affinity Publisher is always my go-to choice. Adobe's mobile apps are generally intended as supplements to the desktop application, something that's focused on a touch interface where you can draw and paint, and then you send that file off to the desktop application for whatever additional work you need to do on it. Adobe does offer a really powerful app called Adobe Capture, which lets you use your smartphone to capture color schemes, textures, even vector shapes from drawings and anything else around you. Affinity provides pretty much full-featured applications, and you get just about all the same stuff that you would in the desktop applications on iPadOS.
Struggling for a spark? Fire up the largest unlimited creative subscription in the world. Find and download authentic graphics, templates, photos, and fonts. Get seriously creative. And go supernova with Envato Elements.
So who should go with Adobe and who should go with Affinity? Well, it largely depends on what industry you're in and what your needs are. For graphic designers, illustrators, and anybody else in communication arts, Affinity is probably a great choice because you can hold on to the application forever, and you can even use it to access work created in other Adobe systems. Motion designers will probably want to stick with Adobe. There really is no clear alternative to After Effects, and when you combine After Effects and Premiere and the rest of the things that you get in the Adobe suite, it does make a lot of sense. For photographers, the choice is a little bit more straightforward. Since Lightroom is available in Adobe, you're probably going to want Lightroom anyway. If you are looking to try to save money and put that extra funding into lenses and better cameras and stuff, it might make sense to go ahead and go with Affinity just to keep costs down, since you can get Lightroom as a standalone and you can still use Lightroom and Affinity, even if it's not quite as tightly integrated or as smooth as Lightroom and Photoshop. At the end of the day, it obviously comes down to your particular needs and your pipeline, your client's pipeline, and the companies that you happen to work with, what they're going to be using. It can be helpful to go ahead and have the Affinity suite on hand, even if you are subscribed to Adobe Creative Cloud, just because it enables you to keep access to your work. Creative Cloud is great for larger teams, but it might be less useful for individuals and freelancers who are working on their own. I'd love to know what you use down in the comments below. And of course, as always, like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.